will start chasing him. And unless the young boy with the shawl is clever enough to outmaneuver them, they will take the shawl away from him. Like so. And the shawl is wandering from one young man to the other. But of course the winner will be the one who can return it to the young girl for a pair of kisses in return. In the background you can admire the grazing and the drinking herd of grey cattle. Remind you of the legs of the horse taking the doggy position. Well, we call it the hunter of the Pusta. And now the horses will take a short break. Be climbing in order to hit at the right moment. It's very easy to miss the block, but of course the clever ones can hit all the three of them. Each lock. Their task is to hit off the blocks, hit the blocks off the locks with the help of their whips. Well, it seems to be easy, but of course it's not that easy. It requires we will check whether there is any wine left in the glasses. carriages were swifter and more elegant than their counterparts, which were used on ordinary weekdays, mainly for work. And you can see that the carriage is drawn by four beautiful Hungarian half-blood horses, who are identically the same color. In this case, there is no space for the cargo, because carriages were used only to transport passengers. However, you can see two benches. The front bench was the place of the driver, who kept the four horses under control and in hands. And the rear seat was the place of the passenger. Formation of the original Coq 5. I think this spectacular stunt deserves a couple of words. Ludwig Coq was actually an Austrian painter who was staying in Hungary for a while. And as the story goes, he had a dream one night, Sven, who decided to make the dream come true. So the first man who was capable of riding five horses at the same time, standing on the backs of the two real horses, was a Hungarian man called Béla Léna. Well, of course, after that, lots of other riders repeated the same stunt, and they even did more than that. Running in the outer circle have to take a different pace from the ones running in the interior circle or inner circle. And just think what would happen if the two real horses decided to separate. Of course, it requires remarkable courage and very extraordinary riding skills and sense of balance.